Hi, everyone. Can you feel what I feel? Drifting through this room, something good is coming soon. Something good is coming soon.
Something good. including the trombone player. So tonight we celebrate the release of my CD. We're going to follow the path of one human being who is trying to get from the wrong life to hopefully a better one and the right one. And conveniently, there's a song that's kind of an overview of that whole trip. And it happens to be the title track of the CD, Plans.
Change for the sky. It's a little boomy. I'm sorry to. Yeah, there it is.
Try that one.
Yeah, try that little one.
Is it
going to
be worse?
No, I just want to hear it. I couldn't hear it.
Mac, are you anywhere near the board over there?
I could
stand. Oh, you've got your thing. I could stand a little more keyboard in the monitor. I was wrong earlier. You were right.
That's never.
Oh my God.
So our protagonist has come up with these plans, and he realizes that it's going to take a while to hatch them. And he discovers that since it's going to take a while, he should probably do a little work on the present also. And Anna, you did a Facebook post the other day that was kind of this next song in a status update. Just, you know, talking about trying to live today with a better attitude. And that's what our protagonist decides to do in this song, which I'll call it now.
do you think?
Yeah, that would be good.
No offense, Dave Francis.
Yes.
He's playing his butt off, baby. He said turn it off, it'd be fun. So.
Oh.
Hi, Dave Provenzano.
Yeah. It's an Easter miracle. Yeah, we'll discuss these musicians and singers in more detail later, but aren't they excellent? I'm so fortunate. Yeah, but back to our protagonist's story, because we do have a loose narrative going tonight. So, our dude, as part of his plan to look at the present with an improved attitude, a part of that is that he decides he's going to take some nice trips. And oh. Yeah. And so on one of these trips where he's kind of taking a break, trying to, you know, survive the present with a better attitude, he finds himself in, I don't know if you can see this, in this ridiculous luxury. Dirt is cheap, but fantastic. And a rooftop pool, private patio overlooking the Pacific in Puerto Vallarta, Mexico. And these little breaks help with surviving all of these plans that he's trying to hatch. And that's what this song is. Thank you. Thank you very much. Let's call all five senses.
It's me.
That'll teach you to talk.
The song's in that key, it's not so bad.
So, vacation over. Our protagonist has to go back home and finish working on all these plans and trying to fix his nasty, messed up life. And, you know, break time over. So one night, he is awakened by a nightmare, and in the middle of the night, he finds himself out in his backyard, having this crisis of faith, crying out to God and the universe, just wanting to know, what is the meaning of all this, and am I going to survive, and what should I be doing? And eventually, he discovers that maybe he wasn't getting the answers because he was asking all the wrong questions. And that's kind of what this song is about.
Bye.
fullest. No, I'm just kidding.
Always a lot of singers, huh?
Yeah, it was there all the time.
So, the good news is that our dude succeeds.
Yay!
To the better life. And when he does, he then turns to his wise, supportive, extremely good-looking significant other and says, thank you for supporting me through all this. I know that wasn't expected. Oh, what's a joke without some tears, right?
That's right.
I know that you signed up for life with someone who was kind of well-adjusted and fun and knew what life was all about, and I'm sorry he was gone for a while there, but he is back, and he's back to stay.
Yeah.
Here goes, who I was, is who I am. Thank you. I'm on my own for a minute. So sorry about the crying that happened. Sometimes I forget that I actually lived all this. Yeah, so, so there was a happy ending, and as we now know, our protagonist was me. It wasn't very mysterious. Not much of a reveal. Sorry. But, and specifically the record, it was and is about my escape from soul-crushing, life-destroying corporate America. I thought that that's what it was about, or all it was about, and I realized after all the songs were finished that it was about other periods also, different times in life, but like getting through years of daily bullying as a kid and getting out of a nasty relationship, emotionally abusive relationship in my 30s. It kind of was all rolled into the same story. It was just the latest incarnation of getting past something into something much better, an upgrade. And I've determined that one of my favorite things about life is that it gives us the opportunity to learn stuff and use the knowledge to make our lives and lives of others better. So that's really what the record is about, I think. And I highly recommend doing that, learning from life and making yours better, because it sure did work out nicely for me. Because I find that this next song is my new type of existence.
Subconscious might shouting out.
Wonderful people who are here with us tonight.
Yeah!
The unrivaled Bob Mader on drums. Yeah! On bass, the ultra cool Dave Francis. Yeah! And members of my chosen family all singing with me tonight, my brothers and sisters, my dear friends, Kathy Hussey. His national stage debut, yeah. Dave Provenzano. Yeah. Oh, and W.T. Davidson on the track. Yeah, anybody who happens to hear a song they recognize, yeah. Please feel free to join us.
Yeah. No. W.T., I thought you were playing trombone on this.
Strong, they learn a little Spanish to get